Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I created this embed code. PayHip allows you to embed codes into your website, and the code gives you more flexibility to add things that don't exist within the website builder, which allows you even more flexibility, and that's the focus of today's video. Now, as a disclaimer, I am not a coder. I don't have a background in coding or computer science or anything like that. I have very general knowledge, but I know how to use PayHip and I know how to use AI programs to generate code for me. So before we get into the details, here's what I created. I have four examples of code that I embedded into the PayHip website. The first is a countdown timer. The next is a calendar generator. Next is a quote. So like a motivational quote, as well as today's date and time is displayed alongside. And the last is a tint and shade generator. These are examples of things that may or may not be useful to your specific business. But the point of this video is to show you the technique. Using that technique, you can create your own code that you can embed in your own website. I'll take you behind the scenes to show you how I created the code. If you want the codes that I have created for this tutorial to test them out yourself or to use them in your own website, not a problem. I will be providing them to you so you can go ahead and copy them and use them for your own projects. That being said, let's test this out. The first is a countdown timer, very straightforward. When you click on the icon, you can select a date and a time, okay? And click on make a countdown and it displays the date and the time here. If you want to clear it out, you can clear and select the date and time that you want. So very basic, very straightforward. There are many use cases for this. Obviously, if you're in a classroom and you want to display a specific time or you have a game, an event, you can use this timer on your website. The next is a copy paste friendly calendar generator. I make lots of calendars in Canva, either for my own designs or when I create templates for the Canva library. To make a calendar in Canva, you can do it manually, but I don't usually do this. I usually use Excel and then copy and paste them into Canva. This makes the process slightly easier. With this, you can select a date. Start from January 1st and we'll go all the way through December. Select Sunday start or Monday start. I'll click on generate calendar. And as you can see, we have an entire year's calendar. And I'll show you how this works when I copy and paste it into Canva. So here's a calendar from July to December 2024. I'm just gonna copy this like so, okay? Control C, and I'm gonna paste this in Canva. Here's a blank Canva design. Right click, paste, or use your shortcut keys, and it pastes the calendar in the form of a table, which makes it so much easier to organize. I can rearrange, change the text, change the size, realign it, or drag this to make an entire monthly calendar. And after adjusting the text sizes, here is what it looks like. To save even more time for the next month, duplicate this page, go back to the calendar. Now we're going to copy August. Copy this, click right at the top, paste, and it changes the entire calendar to the August calendar. Repeat for September, October, November, and December. And within a few seconds, you can create an entire calendar from scratch. If you just want to print it out, I do have a button that allows you to generate a printer-friendly version, and you can print it out, or you can save it as a PDF. The next is a simple quote, and you can have this displayed somewhere on your website or wherever you want it displayed, and the quote would change every day. Or if you want to see a new quote, you can click on new quote and it changes it to a new quote. And the last is something that I use all the time when I make designs, either when I'm designing templates in Google Sheets or when I'm making Canva templates. Let's say, for example, I like this color, okay, but it's a little bit too dark. I want a lighter version of the same color. Once you paste the X code here, it will develop lighter versions of that color and darker versions of this color. This is something that I find very useful. What's nice about this is that it's all in one place. So if I need to use the shade generator right here, if I need to use the calendar, it's right here as well. That being said, let's go over to my AI account so I can show you how I generated this code. I use two programs to create the codes. I use Claude and I use ChatGPT. These two programs are available for free. Claude recently upgraded their program, and it actually works a lot better, especially if you're using it to create code. And it's this 3.5 Sonnet. It's really fast and it's really accurate. I started with providing it an image of what I want it to look like, and this is what it created. You can preview what it looks like before you copy it. Here is the monthly calendar example. You can see the prompt I used was very basic, and it created something really basic. I tested it out and I added more information, and I ended up with the final version. This version is one that you can toggle to select between Sunday and Monday. And I added a button that allows you to save or print. Okay. And here's the one I used for a quote of the day. And then I asked it to modify, and this is the final version that I used. The next is the color picker palette generator. And I created the prompt. It created this version, which was fine, but I didn't like how it looked. And then I made some additional modification, and this is the final version that I ended up using. Okay, and here's what the code looks like. I mean, this is something I will never be able to do on my own. All right, so now I'm going to switch over to ChatGPT to show you what that conversation looked like. We are in my ChatGPT account, and here is a prompt I started out with. Very similar to what I use in Claude, and it basically created a code. Like I pointed out before, unlike Claude, you just don't get that preview. Although the results were similar, I did prefer the one that I got from Claude AI. Here is a prompt that I use to create a fixed countdown. I use the same image here to display kind of an idea of what it should look like. But in this prompt, what I said was, I want a fixed date and time. So instead of having a place where you can select the date and the time and start calendar, I wanted the widget or the code to already come pre-programmed. Here's the part where I added my event date and time. So I said my event July 3rd at this time. So set the timer to that fixed date and time. It gave me the code, and that code worked fine, but I did ask it to make some more modifications. I ended up with this version. Let's copy this code and take it back to PayHip. Okay, we are in my PayHip account. Navigate to Store Builder. Before we move on, I want to point out that for the embed code function to work, you have to have your own domain connected to PayHip. PayHip does have a resource help page that shows you the step-by-step process, so you can check that out. The other thing to point out is that you cannot preview the code once you place it here, unlike the rest of the page. So as you're creating these sections, you can preview it, what it looks like on your desktop and on a mobile device. But for the code, you can't preview it. You have to publish the website first. Here is the code embeds page. This is a custom page, so I'll show you how to create one from scratch, but this is what it looks like. We're going to create a custom page, click on add, custom page, and I'm going to name this demo embed codes. Click on add. Okay, so now we have a blank page. I want it to show up here so it's easy to access. Go to header, navigation links, edit navigation links, and I'm going to add the link here. Okay, demo embed code, and search for the name demo embed. Okay, click on that and add navigation. Okay, so now it shows up here. Okay, and apply changes, save changes. Okay, so here's the one I already created. This is the example. And here's the one we're going to build from scratch. So to add the demo code, very straightforward, add a section, embed code, click on that, and I'll type a header and see what it looks like. And we can always remove it. Here, I'm going to paste the code that I copied from ChatGPT. Okay. And save. Remember, we get this message here that we cannot preview the code until it's live, which is fine. So we're going to click publish. You always have to publish to view the changes. Now I can easily navigate to demo embed codes. And here's what it looks like. So I have the countdown, day, hour, minutes, and seconds. As you can see, unlike the other one, this does not display the picker option where you can select the date and the time. So if you just wanted to use this for an event and you wanted your own inbuilt timer, you can do this. Now we're gonna go back and remove this and paste the examples from Claude AI. Here is the version I am going to copy. Toggle to code and click on the copy icon. And we're gonna paste that here. Click Save Changes, Publish, and let's check it out. Click on Demo, Embed Codes, and here's what it looks like. So I will toggle it to Monday Start. select July 1st and go all the way down to December 31st. Click on Generate Calendar, and here's what it looks like. So it works fine. You can save it or you can print it out directly. All right, so I'll show you one more example using the color tints and shades. First, add another section, embed code, grab that, paste that here. I want the background to be different. So what I'm gonna do is go to color scheme and change this to white. Okay, so that way there's a demarcation between the first code box and the second code box. Save changes, publish. Click on demo embed codes link, and here we go. And here is the color tint and shade generator. You can just delete this. Enter your hex code here, click on generate. It creates lighter versions of it and it creates darker versions of it. Okay, to wrap up this tutorial, let's take a look at some other examples. Your use case obviously will vary, but these are just examples for you to play around with if you wanted to check out this feature of using this code with your website. And here are some examples, a weather widget, to-do list, note-taking tool, although I'm not sure how this is going to work. Here's where I got the idea for the quote of the day and the color picker palette. So play around with this, find what works for your website so you can customize it to your own specific needs. If you want copies of this code, I will provide it for free, but they will be saved on my Patreon page. So go ahead and check it out over there. I will, of course, leave links in the description box below. If you have ideas of things that you want me to generate using Claude and embedding them in the PayHip website, also let me know. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.